Behold, a new day is dawning in the land. The Spirit of God is moving, calling His people to rise up and shine. He's calling each and every one of us to take the hope that we have to the lost all around us. The hope that is Jesus. In a nation that's so full of darkness, a time for the light has arrived. The harvest is plenty, so let's be ready to go. You might be thinking, oh, what can I do? But trust in the Lord.
He living God, you have won the victory over all our sins, over death, over sickness, Lord. And God, so we will raise a cry. May our lives glorify your name in everything that we do, everywhere that we go, Lord God. Oh, we bless your name, Lord. Of creation bow to His name, and every nation will shout His fame. We raise the anthem of praise, let it be known to all that Christ is here. Sacrifice number two, to be led by God. Number three, worship is a journey into the presence of God. Number four, worship is personal. Number five, worship involves trust. Number six, worship involves the physical and the spiritual. Okay, if we're gonna stop only at singing and playing, we miss the bus. That's not worship, that's performing. Worship involves the spiritual. Okay? Now, okay, he didn't stop halfway. Abraham did not stop. At any point, he kept on with what God had told him to do. Okay? Worship involves going all the way. Worship involves giving 100% to God.
Thank you.
to share a little testimony of what happened last week. First of all, I really miss church. And I was on my way back. Actually, I had gone to visit my sister. Boarded the plane. I reached Delhi safely the next morning. It was fine, and I finally reached there. And I thank God that I was able to be there and pray for my nephew, because she's surrounded by all unbelievers there. And but God made a way. It was impossible. I had this thing inside me, because there were so many things against my going there that I knew God was going to make a way. But God made a way, and I just reached on the nick of time, and I was able to go there. So I praise God for that. And God is always on the throne. God always controls. And I believe, because I had this burden to go, and I knew that God wanted me to go. And sometimes when there are a lot of obstacles, sometimes you have this even greater conviction that, you know, God is in it. And God is going to prove that He can get you to do the impossible. Amen. On that note, can we all look to the Lord today? great and mighty, Lord. Lord, we rejoice in your presence as we go from this place, oh God. We rejoice. King of majesty, I have one desire, just to be with you, my Lord. Just to be with you, my Lord. King of majesty, I have one desire, just to be with you, my Lord. We give our praises to you. Bless your name, Jesus. You are the Savior of my soul, and forever and ever give my praises to you, oh God. Lord, we want to thank you so much for your presence in our midst. As we go from this place, we pray that you would be with us, and we pray that you bless our time of fellowship together. We just want to thank you once again for everything. In the name of Jesus we pray, amen. God bless you and have a great week.
Jesus, I love to praise your name. Jesus, you're my Lord and King. I come to you and rejoice before your throne. I want to be in your presence forevermore. Jesus, I love to praise your name. Jesus, you're my Lord and King. We are yours and yours alone. We belong to you, to no one else but you.